Hi everyone, today I am giving you explanation on the topic the watering eye. This is the watering eye part 1. Let's move to its definition. It is characterized by overflow of tears from the conjunctival sac. Now in case of watering eye, there is an overflow means excessive flow of the tears from the conjunctival sac. Here the conjunctival sac is present inside the lower eyelid where the eyeball as well as the lower eyelid attached together. There is a small hole is present which is known as a conjunctival sac, in which the drop is instilling in this picture. Now, watering eye occurs due to, in each and every patient, out of these two reasons, only one reason is responsible for the watering eye. It may be hyperlacrimation or it may be epiphora. Hyperlacrimation means excessive secretion of tears. In this case, tears get secreted very excessive or in a very high quantity. And epiphora, it means obstruction of the outflow of normally secreted tears. In this case, tears get secreted normally, but there is an obstruction in the drainage of the tears. That's why epiphora occurs. Etiology, or we can say causes. First one is primary hyperlacrimation and the second one is reflex hyperlacrimation. So let's discuss one by one. First one is primary hyperlacrimation. It is a rare condition. First of all, it is very rare condition which occurs due to stimulation of the lacrimal gland. In this case, the messages are sent to the lacrimal gland for the watering, due to which the watering occurs. Okay. Next one, it may also occur in the early stages of lacrimal gland tumors. Sometimes it may occur in the early stages. Sometimes the tumors get developed in the lacrimal gland. The word tumor means abnormal cell growth, so due to this it occurs. And cyst, due to the effect of strong parasympathomimetic drugs. Sometimes people use strong parasympathomimetic drugs which attack on our peripheral nervous system, due to which the cyst develop and the primary hyperlacrimation occurs. Move to the next one, which is reflex hyperlacrimation. It results from the stimulation of sensory branches of fifth nerve due to irritation of cornea and conjunctiva. Now in this case, stimulation of the sensory branches of fifth nerves occur. Messages are sent to the sensory branches of fifth nerve due to irritation of cornea and conjunctiva. Now that irritation of cornea and conjunctiva is there, the messages are sent in this form. Due to this, reflex hyperlacrimation occurs. It may occur due to these conditions. Now these conditions are responsible for the reflex hyperlacrimation. First one is affections of the lid. The word affections means abnormability. Abnormability of the lids. Second one, affections of conjunctiva. Third one, affections of cornea. And the fourth one, affections of sclera. Let's see one by one. First one is affections of the lid. Now these are the following abnormalities takes place in the lids. First one is stye. Painful yellowish lump is present on the outside of the lid, or we can say it is present on the upper eyelid. Okay. Second one is meibomitis. It is the inflammation of the meibomian gland. Meibomian glands are present inside the tarsal plates, so they get inflamed. Third condition related to the lids is tracheiasis, which means misdirection of the lid margin. It includes mainly entropion, means inward direction or interning of the lid margin. Let's move to the next, affections of conjunctiva. Now conjunctiva, in the case of conjunctiva, inflammation of conjunctiva takes place, for which we will use the word conjunctivitis. Now the inflammation of the conjunctiva may be, it may be allergic, it may be infective, and it may be traumatic. Traumatic means it is due to the injury or trauma. Third one is affections of cornea. Under the conditions of the cornea, three conditions are there. First one is corneal abrasions. The word abrasions means scratches like is seen on the cornea. Second one, corneal ulcers. Ulcers are the whitish spots which are present on the cornea. And third one is non-ulcerative keratitis. There is an inflammation of the cornea, but ulcers are not present here. Next and the last condition is affections of sclera. Two kinds of affections of sclera are present. First one is episcleritis. Now, in front of the sclera, there is a layer which is present and it is called episclera. So inflammation of that front layer of the sclera is there, which is known as episcleritis. And the second condition is scleritis. The word scleritis means inflammation of the sclera. Now, it was the end of the watering eye part 1. Thanks for your patience listening.